All right, here we go. Another test recording. Starting up game. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4 Mississippi, 5 Mississippi, 6 Mississippi, 7 Mississippi, 8 Mississippi, 9 Mississippi, 10 Mississippi, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Everything is out of sync. 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Alright, so it took roughly 30 seconds for the game to load. Some builds of the game load much faster, and some much slower. I'm not sure what it is that makes this change. But this is definitely one of the slower versions. And sometimes I will get a not responding notice up on my top bar. Anyway, after what happened with the last playtest, let's see how far I get today. Alright, here we go. And yes, at some point I'm going to try out the boss mode. Okay, there is a skip. I was curious how soon into the cutscene the skip would occur. So the other day on Discord we were discussing Mets and a variety of other things. Pointing out that I do really enjoy the original new variations on certain enemies here, such as these Red Alert Tellies and Red Alert Mets. I love them. They have great color. Same goes with the Fez Mets in Dune. Oh, game decided to freeze a second again. It's been a while since I saw that. I'm still pretty certain that that small freeze is my end only, so... Thank you. Okay, yeah, I'm noticing the additional background. So for now, we're settling on gray. I know that Nico and Tom had issues with the color, but you know, I enjoy the color. So if there were like various different shades of blue or pink or whatever on the border, I think that would be nice. Gray is nice too, but yeah. Or even rainbow. I'll go with rainbow colors. Okay, roll. Beetle. Okay. So another thing from the Discord today, I believe. You guys are discussing that Beetle and Dune's stages seem a little empty or too easy. So going through this, I'm going to look at my sentiments on that. First of all, we have the caterpillars from Mega Man 4. What exactly do we call these things? Leaf blades or something? I don't know. But yeah, I know they're from 9. And then we have one of your new original enemies here, which are kind of a take on one of the cannons from Mega Man 4, but with a different look. And then, of course, the Rhino Beetle tanks. Let's see, if I was to add anything, I would probably put an enemy right here. What kind? I don't know. Like, how early do you want to introduce the caterpillar that transforms into the moth? Or maybe just put another plain caterpillar here, or something else entirely. Considering that Plant Man is fleeing the stage, you could almost consider that this is somewhat related to his area from Mega Man 6. And then of course Honey Woman is also involved, but you only see Hornet Man themed enemies in the next section. So maybe something new and original could also be added to the stage, or we could repurpose something from Plant Man stage, such as the, are they crickets or grasshoppers? I forget. But something like that, maybe. Yes, expect dogs. Alright, can I get rid of my rust here and actually take out Honey in one attempt? Yes, I can. The whole trick is to get rid of those two particular bees. Thank you. this whole stretch that we're in now could maybe use a little bit more of enemy variety. But what? Like, I'm not sure you want something exactly here that's going to screw the player over on the final jump. But yeah, there's something that's missing in there. That whole final stretch needs something. There's, what, a couple of cannons and one of the leaf blade wheel things and, what, two or three of the moths. Like, going back again to my idea of throwing in maybe the Plantman grasshoppers, or what else is in that stage? I'm thinking more along the lines of actual foresty, animal-y, insect type of creatures. I think that's mostly it. Okay, there's those flying beetle things that jet across the stage when you're in that springboard area toward the end. The up and down piranhas, they probably wouldn't be appropriate unless you had water down here. And then there's that big gorilla mini boss, which you wouldn't need either, unless you made your own miniature version of it that would roll around and fire its fists off. Okay. On to the boss itself. Almost. I was thinking too much about what to try and add to the battle. The battle itself seems pretty straightforward. I know there was talk of maybe alternating something, but I don't know, I like it as is. I don't know. Like, the boss fight is definitely easier with roll, because of a double jump. I guess it would be awkward if the robot masters acted differently depending on who they're fighting. So, like, the pattern we just saw could be the same for Mega Man, but if the AI were to detect that Beetle is fighting Roll, then maybe an additional attack would be added. I don't know. Okay, on to Dune. Dune's design is still... It's good, but as I mentioned in a previous playthrough, it still looks like she's got a beard rather than a veil. Maybe the veil has to be a different color than gray. Something that doesn't stand out like she's got a beard. Ah yes, Fezmets, and what do they call those things again? Wheel cutters? I forget. Now, what could possibly be missing from this stage? I don't know. Let me go back here for a second. Yeah, like, I kind of still feel like there should be flowing sand here. Okay, so Met, Wheel Cutter, and then there's no threat here. What could be added in here? Like, here's your teaching element on the scales. Maybe put another Met on the right scale? And the scale will react to its weight? That might be kind of neat. Or perhaps this opening here, if it is an opening, if it's supposed to be like a door, you could make it so that some form of a Arabian telly could come out. And that could happen throughout the other door openings throughout the stage. And yeah, I just love the water here. But there isn't much of it throughout the stage. Maybe there should be more. I don't know. Alright, there's water down here. But this is underground, sort of. Like, I like it in the palm tree areas. I'm still curious what this whole underneath portion is here for. Like, I know that you can go under if you have the bubble, but otherwise it's not really required. Like, you have this gap, obviously you can go under there, but there's nothing else. Like, here we have the E-tank. Maybe if there were something, I don't know, adjacent me. Could even be behind a false wall. But then you've already got the E-tank wide out in the open, so putting something else secret, I don't know. Every time I see these square gaps in the wall, I think a telly's gonna come out, but there aren't any. Obviously, some are just shadows, while some aren't. So yeah, here we have a couple of wheel cutters that come at you. In a previous playthrough, I mentioned having a Pippi drop something down on you here. Or something else entirely. Because I was reminded of the section right before Proto Man and Hard Man stage. And I'm thinking, okay, something would want to drop down on me here. In that stage, it's bees. Okay, we had the Fez Met. I really like that Met in particular. Sniper Joe. Okay, now here come the actual Pippies. Or whatever you're calling them, because obviously they will have a different name. In this particular section, it reminds me of other areas from past games. So, as an example, whenever you come up that one particular ladder in Centaur Man toward the end of the stage, and you'll have that squid right about here. Now, in this portion, you have this Pippi come on off screen. Maybe if that Pippi were removed, this Fezmet were removed, and something bigger were right here. Although the question is what? I don't know if a big eye is appropriate. Obviously you could do that. And I think Tom was complaining about this jump. Again, if you're coming in here as Mega Man, it is obviously harder. But it's like nothing with Roll. I just really like the stage. Dog in the room, by the way. He's wanting attention. Alright, onto this. Now, as for what could be done with Doom, well, she really catches you off guard still. Like, I'm trying to pay attention to her. I do feel that her attack should do more damage to the drones. Because with her weakness, she is incredibly easy. And there's Rush. Good boy. Alright, so, my addition has been added, right? No. Or am I thinking a different pit? Okay, so here's the thought. What is this sliding portion for exactly? Maybe there needs to be something that you're actually sliding in here to get. A couple of small health energy? I don't know. Okay, hold on here. I'm trying to get this correct. Sometimes I'm not making contact. Okay. Doesn't matter. It is a one-tile gap, so I'm not expecting to always go through it. Ooh, you got away from me, did you? So, it has to be facing me in order to react to me? Is that what I was getting there? I did not want to slide there. Now the checkpoint is ahead of me, so I should be able to go back, yes. Thank you for the one up back. Thank you for the one up Eddie. Darn it. Thought I had enough time. Thank you. This could use an enemy in here. And here. Even though I know you have the Met coming up quite soon after. Maybe if the Met from here was removed and something else was in this gap. Those helicopter cannon enemies, I forget what they're called. They're from Mega Man 6. You normally see them in Wind Man and other stages. You introduce your own variation in the Proto Man stage in this game. Maybe some of them should be added to this stage. Because it seems like a fitting place for them. And I still feel that this whole battle should take place outdoors. And I slid when I should have gone the other way. So let's get in some Buster action before we go back to Dust Storm. See, I think the missiles are going to go over my head, but they actually stop right on me. They explode right on top of me. Okay. Yeah, I tend to come back in here to get this one up. Are there any other breakable blocks besides this one and the one that leads to Fireman that I'm not remembering? Alright, Tide, back to you. Thank you. An enemy could be used in here, since there isn't much on the last screen. Again, what? Maybe introduce the snail here. It could be down on this platform or something and fire up at you. Because otherwise you get introduced to it right before the mini-boss. Maybe put a large health under here? I don't know. Love the intro with the fish. Should have moved. Now, if I saw that correctly, the explosion when it hit the wall still hit him, which is a good touch. Beat. For some reason, I want to hear Tango meow. Talking about different enemies that could be added in, obviously one of your best influences for enemies in the game come from Dr. Wily's Revenge. Are there any that have been left out that you might want to put in? Pretty much covered everything that I can think of off the top of my head. Okay, the Lightning Lords were in Elecman, which were of course then also part of Airman in 2. Although the way they worked in Dr. Wily's Revenge was horrible. Thank you. Fun, fun, fun. So cute. Watch where you're going when there's bladers about. Of course, I was on my last life anyway, so I'm actually kind of glad I died. I just love how that whole thing is done. Not only do you breathe the attack, which is awesome, but then the water drips and creates this pool. This is wonderful. Aha, all right, this Met's been moved. Very nice. Missed. Thank you. Okay, I thought I had enough jump room there. Good stage. Love that bit with Eddie. Thank you. I was expecting to go off the ledge and dip underneath, but apparently I just kept going forward right into the beam. So yesterday on the Discord, I'm reading that Nico completely forgot where the metal mommies were. And then it got me thinking, maybe introduce them in this stage. Okay. I thought I was going to make that. Wrong way. I never did discover Dagger's weakness, because I'm pretty certain that the fire breath worked on Honey. Oh, this music, I love it. Not bad. Not bad. I'm getting better. Then I'm already sweaty, so... Good duel. He won. And game over. Let's continue. I love that fight. Thank you. Who would ever think that the water-related weapon in the game would be the most useful in an electric stage? Geez, the battle started out so well, then all of a sudden I'm getting hit half one after the other. Yeah, I shouldn't have been placing so much emphasis on trying to get rid of that mitt. It's unnecessary if I can just pass it. I'm curious if that thing should shock me if I have the bubble equipped when it hits, rather than just pop the bubble. Okay. Sometimes I think he's too easy with his weakness. I don't know. That's just me. Onward. Still hilarious. Like, sorry, Matt, but you had to be that sick sacrificial test subject. I love their intros. Oh, right, I'm not Mega Man. Now, you're originally weak to Dust Crusher, so my first thought would be... Nope, you are not weak to that. I should be doing this badly at the fight. Didn't mean to slide there. Okay, so yeah, you come out here and I'm still expecting some kind of health after facing him. Because you come down here and you're immediately taking on these guys. Like, I don't know, two give you health, one gives you Eddie, this one gives you nothing. So I'm curious as to why. Thank you. Yeah, that's what I meant to do. Forgotten if there was something over there, and I believe there was, but yeah, I don't want to go for it right now. Right, there's a yeah, I don't feel like dying right now. Again. Yeah, the guys were asking how to get out of that. I'm still confused. She's definitely the most difficult robot master in the game, I find. Most of the others could be done Buster only. And I know that some of the other playtesters have done Ghost Buster only. So it is doable. I just need to learn it. Right now, I don't feel is the time when I do the other mode. I feel it will be safer to do a Buster only there. Yeah, I'm still not sure about that jet jump, because it doesn't look like it does anything. Like, how much of an actual boost are you getting? Very nice. I just like the cutscene. pay those things. Okay, I feel this is the boss I have the least experience with, but let's go for it. Okay, I wasn't expecting the blow up. It's a fun boss. It's not too overcomplicated. Also, the suggestion of making the name of that thing ICU, Intruder Control Unit, was awesome. Okay. Been a little while since I did these stages. This obstacle here is the most difficult in the game, in my opinion. It's that one on the bottom. Like it's always gonna hit me. Unless I do that. I'm still curious if there should be an item placed there, if you're going to put something to slide in with a spike. And I'm still not used to that. Yeah, it's been too long. No. Because I shot it more than once. Jeez. Yep. The last time I played the stage, I was getting so good at it. Alright, my first attempt at doing that quick kill. See if I can manage it. No, I'm doing something incorrect. Maybe I'm supposed to fire at all? I'm supposed to make him light up. Anyway, moving on. Am I even damaging it? I don't think I'm damaging it. Yeah, I'm not damaging it. All those shots. I wasn't even noticing until then. Okay, let me try again. I'm assuming it's going to take damage now. Yes, it is. Thank you. Not sure what that sound is all about, but whatever. Let's continue. Sorry. Right, I forgot about that. Thank you, honey one. Thank you. I keep thinking I'll get that early. Damn this cough. Oh, jeez. Alright, I have some tanks, and I would rather not go through the stage again. Let's see if I can actually get this to work. I see. And I forgot to use a tank. Oh well. It helps me get better with the stage, right? I forget if this was a checkpoint, but yeah, I like that you have the nod to the Metal Daddy. If this wasn't a checkpoint, because I can't remember, we were discussing other Mets, and maybe the 1000, the train, there could be one right here. I don't know. Just a thought. You were thinking of putting at least one in. Thank you. Okay. Apparently sliding didn't work because I was still ramming up against something. Thanks for that one. Ah, Jesus Christ. Those things do go slightly too fast. Just saying. For being in such close quarters. And you are, then again, you are in the Wily stages, and it's supposed to be a little more difficult, so I can understand. But I don't know, it's like the hit detection on the slide is telling me that the pile driver is still there, so I stop. Yeah, that time I tried to just keep going. That one's nasty. Alright, let's give this another shot. Much better. So yeah, you just have to learn how to angle the shot. Technically, yes. I'm still wondering how you get the one up. I still feel that the one-hit spikes here need to have a different color other than purple to signify where they are. Did I move forward? Okay, refresh my lives. Trying to go too fast. Yes, my fault again. Hmm. Now this itch on my finger wants to kill me. Watch where you're jumping. You were supposed to land behind the Joe, not on the spikes. This is what happens when you don't play a game for over a week. Yeah, right, that's the checkpoint. May as well take it. Did I not trigger Shadow Roll? Timing is so off here. Come on, almost done the game. We've only found one major glitch. I supercharged the big bulb and he wouldn't take any damage. Is that supposed to happen? I don't know. Well, obviously not, because it's completely unfair, but... Game wants to freeze, okay. Thank you for that. Okay. Small break. Like, really small. Let me compose my mind for a minute or so here. Meanwhile, this itch just won't stop. Ugh. Probably have to put some cream on it. All right, cream, and we will continue. Okay. Man, this stage is giving me wrath today. Man, the first time I did this, over a week ago, I did not have this many problems with this stage. Oh, okay. The music didn't just stop, I had a small freeze. Finally out of that room. Okay. So Skull still has a problem here. Does he teleport out? No, he's still back there. But the generator is destroyed. Was that jump always that wide? Oh, right. Double jump. Die. Remember what character you're using. Still got two extra eyes. Okay. Gotta remember that these are the finally the boss after how many deaths? Much better. Oh, I'm happy that one's over. Jeez, I've been going over 2 hours. Wow. Thank you. Mega Man go down the hole. And there goes that fault. Nope. Oh well, I needed the game over anyway. In Tide and this stage, for some reason I want to see more than just fish go by. It's starting to remind me of Acid Man in the background, where you can see all the garbage and Acid Man himself. That could be an idea for Tide stage. Show him swimming by in the background, just a silhouette. Now, I haven't been in here if you've changed anything. It's doesn't appear that you have. And I didn't mean to do that. Nope. Of course that had to happen. I don't know, the whole section isn't really that difficult to me. I know it bugged the other guys, but a lot of stuff bugs the other guys. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, I kind of like just using Storm more. But I like what you've done with Polar and Missile. Alright, so this decision again. I'm actually going to pass on the proto stage. Yeah, those things. I'm thinking you should add them to a missile stage. And yes, one of these One of these playtests, I'm going to go in here without the allies and see if I can go through all 12 or 13 bosses in this stage. It'll be hectic, sure. Okay. think I failed to double jump there. Enough lives, yeah. Okay. She has a lot of damage. Let's see here. Oh, right here. Still have a proto. Oh, right. Final stretch. Here we go. Yeah, so good call up here. Like, I would have never noticed that. Okay. Why'd it hit me? Reset posture here. Ah. Okay. Right, last life. Yada 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 yada. Okay, now we finish. Thank you. Okay. Sweaty palms, sweaty fingers, sweaty, 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 sweaty. Why does touching the... Okay, I kind of deserve that. did not mean to switch characters. Finally. Of course the game decides to freeze. Yeah, I do not feel like repeating anything here. Start on the capsule. Oh, that's good to know. And finally, that is over. With 50 seconds left to spare at a 3-hour run. Well, I had fun. And yes, lots of room to improve. Eventually awaiting the game's release when we're going to race it, because that'll be fun. Very nice. Credits! Still love that. Yep, you do a fantastic job. There I am. Doesn't really seem like it, but I'm curious if the blue text for our usernames is a little too dark. I was clearly capable of reading it, but I'm just wondering. For other people that might have color issues. Yep, the dedication is always fun there too. Love it. All right, I think that does it. Until next time.